Thank you, everybody. Delighted to be here. And as then, or rather cautioned, I would say that it should not be a sales pitch or a pitch to people sitting here, which of course it would not be. And I'm mindful of the fact that good ideas need to be relevant. That has been the genesis for this program or venture that I got the good fortune of initiating when I was associated with Dr. Reddy's lab in Andhra Pradesh around 6 years back. And I could also hear today that Professor Arun Mehra talked about the process orientation required and not necessarily to blame the environment, which a lot of my fellow social entrepreneurs would tend to when they see the first signs of hostility or not growing as per their business plans. Professor Mehra also talked about adaptation flexibility in terms of models, localized models, and not necessarily the McDonald's approach as we have been talking about, or as it has been the kind of, the most quoted platform for such intervention and services. And I have a question here, a very minor one for this very August gathering. What's the kind of number of kilometers in roads that India builds today, every day, as part of its, national highway program? What's the kind of kilometer length per day that we create in India? 14 or 40?
14.
14, okay. Any other responses to this?
20.
Sorry?
20.
So both these are absolutely correct. So we are kind of, targeting 20 kilometers and we are actually clocking around 14 kilometers. We are actually now 29 states strong, if I include Telangana. And I have spent part of my life at Hyderabad. So it's like half a kilometer per day per state, right? And we are the third largest economy in the world right now. It's interesting. On the same note, I would like to just inquire about safe drinking water or clean water, which all of us almost have taken for granted in a metropolis like Delhi. How many of our fellow countrymen are currently deprived or devoid of that? What's the kind of extent of that? Any guesses? Simple. This is not a quiz session. IITians are the best at quizzing. So I leave it aside for a different evening. But in terms of clean water, which is such a basic thing, how many of us in this country, which is the third largest economy, one of the strongest in Asia, how many of us are deprived of clean drinking water? 70% is the front row answer and 99% is the front row from the back answer. It's a guess, okay? 99%, okay? Any other guesses? 63 million, okay. So I would essentially say that all of those would be correct and incorrect because again, contamination in water is such a thing which is not visible. And that's the very basis of we being deprived of this invaluable basic need. So as per the last estimates, more than 700 million people in our country, which is close to 60% of the total population, is devoid of clean water. And that's what kind of spurred me and encouraged me to kind of work in this sector and to take a crack by bringing in an enterprise-based model through eHealth Point. And I got the good fortune of associating with Dr. Anji Reddy, who is no more now, but in 2006-07, I worked with him in instituting the first model, enterprise-based model, for bringing in clean water to rural villages and small towns, starting with Andhra Pradesh. And since then, it has been adopted by at least 5 state governments directly. And then currently, more than 4,000 communities are benefiting from an enterprise-based model, wherein they pay 10 paisa to 12 paisa a liter for getting clean water. And that water is clearly devoid of any chemical contamination or microbiological contamination or things like that. Just compare that paying 15 rupees for a bottle of packaged water, but our fellow countrymen in those 4,000 communities continue to get that water at 10 paisa, 12 paisa, 15 paisa a liter day after day, right? Now, again, going by the same number orientation, if we were to build only a single unit in every state every day, we would be reaching out to more than 5,000 people every day. That means on a simple mathematical basis, 50 lakh people every month, 6 crore people a year. And all of that at a cost of just 500 rupees per person. And you get clean water for next 20 years, 25 years on the dot. So, you know, without further going into those details, I'll come back to, you know, essentially what I have been interested to talk about in terms of possibility of scaling up of an enterprise which caters to basic need, taking care of the innovation aspect and introducing technology. I've already mentioned about this. There are 10 larger states which have more than 200,000 communities which are not having clean drinking water. And despite we being the third largest economy in the world, that's a real challenge that all of us should take head on. Whenever I have made investor pitches in last few years in India, outside India, everybody talks to me about the total addressable market. Now that's a typical business phenomena, right? What is the potential market, total addressable market, percentage of revenue that will come out of that, customer segmentation, preferences, power to pay, willingness to purchase, and things like that. For me, just go back please. For me, this makes a very clear, simple statement. Our Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, very clearly in his speech has said that more than 73% of people will feel proud. Means everybody will feel proud, but more than 73% of people still do not have access to clean drinking water. That's the, you know, addressable market or potential for us, all of us. The solution that we have deployed has been a very basic solution. It has four components very clearly visible there. Each of those components are anchored by e-health point. In terms of community mobilization, ascertaining the need, the demand, generating awareness, creating a solution which is customized to local areas, something Professor Mehra talked about, flexibility of deployment, operations and maintenance, which again continues to be a bane in most of such infrastructure projects, whether it is health, water, education. And I must add here that our Hubli sandbox has been a sterling example, but again, only one example of a comprehensive, universal, holistic development, and that needs to be replicated. And then distribution and outreach. Again, Desh talked about the assessment part, the distribution part, the implementation part, and monitoring part. So we have tried to roll those elements into this model. And in terms of financing, it is not dependent on charity or only government largesse. It is a very useful mix of impact investment funds, which is basically equity into this enterprise, public-private partnership funds, wherein we co-establish these units along with the state governments and district administration, and CSR funds, which are yet to arrive, but then that's a possible source, especially with the new companies bill getting passed earlier this week. And in terms of operating expenses, all of those operating expenses are met by the unit's performance itself. So there is absolutely no subsidy or cross-subsidy to be involved there. Next, please. Distribution has emerged as a key component. Not everybody is able to come to a water station every day. And then distribution also ensures that the kind of efficiency of the capital invested is maximized. So to that extent, a very simple model, set up a water station, clean water, provide it to people who are nearby, and reach out to people through a doorstep delivery at a little additional incremental cost. That generates employment as well. Next, please. In terms of a summary of quick benefits, and these can be further quantified, there are several economists sitting in this August forum, but I've tried to make it very, very simple. This model, for every location that it works, provides employment directly to two people, and we prefer women to be employed here in these water stations. It provides great degree of environmental returns, eliminates the need to overdraw water, eliminates the need to boil water. Also in terms of social returns, of course, savings on medical expenditure, which otherwise is close to more than $120 a year per family in rural settings. Savings on wages due to the missed days, otherwise because of contaminated water consumption. Positive impact on gender equity. We have seen that more and more males are picking up this water in water stations across various states wherever it has been implemented. And then improved lifestyle for people, because just imagine if they can save $100 a year, they are able to employ it for several other things as well, notably in terms of lifestyle improvements by virtue of education and also investing in terms of savings. Next, please. In terms of our engagement with the government, and this is to illustrate that in last 6 years, this has reached to 4,000 communities, and I would say only 4,000 communities. Think about the UID program, which is now reaching to almost 400 million people in a short span of 3 years. And in terms of resource deployment, in terms of massive planning, as compared to that, this would be like not even needing 1/4 of that time and attention and resources. The unmet need is so high that we need to reach out to at least 50,000 larger similar communities in next 4 to 5 years at a rapid scale. In terms of what could come from government, and DASRA report has very clearly outlined that sharing of information is a vital piece in this. And we look forward to that sharing of information happening for not only this enterprise, but for similar enterprises who are working in coordination with government to bring such a vital service to the community. In terms of recognizing and quantifying these value of these localized projects across various states, Bengal may have an arsenic problem, or Rajasthan has a fluoride problem. In terms of use of technology for monitoring service delivery, again, there has been a very recent kind of, you know, unhappy state of midday meal program in Bihar, but that doesn't mean midday meal program is completely flawed all across. So again, technology can come very well in monitoring the quality of service delivery, right from installation to satisfied customers responding, and that will be a vital component. Water is a product, a service which cannot get contaminated even by 1%. No quality dilution. In terms of the treatment should be basically in terms of an infrastructure and a service combination to enhance its impact, its coverage, its scaling up. And then policy support through the PPP mode. In most places, we have seen that techno-commercial tendering or bidding is the only route right now for such projects, which has its own ills. And I don't want to dwell in detail upon those ills. But again, if it is treated as a combination of social innovation, service, and a fast-track mechanism on a mini-projects mode, every such location can benefit out of that. So that's essentially what I wanted to share in the allotted 10 minutes to me. I'm extremely thankful for the time and attention. And I'll be able to kind of, you know, respond to any questions or queries that you may have immediately after this, as well as during the course of the day. Thank you very much.